Left it there for Nyquist. Back pass to Cronwall. To Gus Nyquist again. Looks back, high slot, Franzen off the goal post. Datsyuk with it again, so this unit's been out the whole time. There's a shot just wide. Franzen couldn't take it off the backboards, off the skate in front. Leg one looking for it, and it stayed out of sprawling Hackett.
Nyquist doesn't like the whistle, thinks it was too quick, and how that didn't go in, I'm not sure.
To develop in Grand Rapids, and they've done a great job. Circling the goal, banging away, Howard, good save there. Datsyuk through center, now into Buffalo territory. One on four, dangled with it, and then lost it. Kindle gave him the puck back. Good play! On to Tarr, let a snapshot go. There's around that time left, just under that now.
Oof.
Back into the middle. Datsyuk gets checked, and still nothing on the board. Shots are 9-8 Sabres. Or afternoon, I should say.
Penalty Buffalo. And then the interference in front of the net, right there. Oh, my God, that was a slew foot.
1 minute. But McBain. For Buffalo, for Gergensen's, couldn't get through, and he dumped Smith.
Another slew foot, Ken.
Look at here.
Jumping.
It sure is.
These are dirty plays, boy.
Yeah.
Tell you what, Brendan Smith got the number for sure.
In front of that, they score! Hodgson threw it in front, and Gergensen's knocked it in.
His long reach came into play here.
Well, he just returned the end of March after missing 11 games to injury.
There was two guys in front of the net, and it may have gone off a skate, not even off the stick. Just a lucky break with the Kaiser covering Gergensen. And is it his skate? You can't tell on this replay. It looks like it, but you guys at home can see it. I can't.
Looked like his right foot.
Well, yeah. Look out. Oh, boy.
Penalty here as Nyquist is hurt.
Oh, boy. Big hit from behind. Jeez.
Penalty coming to Buffalo.
Face first, right into the glass. God dang it. He turned there. Oh, jeez.
That's Weber.
He didn't even know he was there. And again, you know, like Brendan Shanahan, NHL, will go, even if they thought this was a suspension, would say, well, he turned back into the hit.
Back of the goal, good turn back, and Shan stopped. Nice play, Nyquist. Intercepted and carried back in by Foligno. Ennis couldn't finish. Tyler Ennis brings it back in, the Sabres' leading scorer in goals and points. 21 goals on the season for Ennis and 42 points.
Cronwall just got hit in the head behind the play.
Franzen pass back, they score! In a 1-1 tie. Cronwall trying to shake off the effects of that, and Brendan Smith shaking off the lethargy here, and the Red Wings back on even terms.
It's a huge goal for Detroit with 7:32 to go in the second period to tie this game, and there's the hit down in the corner. Cronwall was stunned for a second. He looked around, the referee looked, no call, but what a beautiful play right there by Franzen to a late coming number two, Brendan Smith, and he rifled it into the net to the side of Hackett. That might have gone off somebody in front of the net, maybe a Sabres player, but nonetheless, 1-1 we have. And Cronwall, I think, is okay, but he got hit pretty good.
I think that was Alfredson, was it not, driving the net. Here comes Gergensen's in, and there's a penalty upcoming here to DeKaiser.
He's still shaking off the hit from the right side. We'll show it to you when we get a chance, but right now, that's out of play.
This is going to be the longest delay of game penalty you've ever seen. I wondered if it wasn't even off near the bench. It was right out to the other end of the ice. Here's Ennis with it. And save made as he gets knocked down. Comes back to the line. Hodgson to the point to Ristolainen. Sabres working around the outside. Ristolainen with it again. It's a 5-on-3 power play. The shot that glanced off Lashoff, who's out with Cronwall and Glendening. Try to fend off this Sabres man advantage. Big Chris Stewart in front, screening. He goes to get it wide. He's got Ennis and Hodgson with him up front. Ehrhoff to Stewart, and that went over the outstretched glove of Howard. Off the glass, comes back to the line to Ehrhoff. Back to Ristolainen with a shot, and Howard will hold on and no rebound. He'll shoot one. Howard the save. What a stop on the rebound. Oh, he stopped Ristolainen in front, and he's got it with the DeKeyser penalty over with 3 seconds left in the Abdelkader penalty.
Well, that was a great eight scoring chance for sure by Buffalo, and two things happened here. First of all, Jimmy Howard made a huge save, and then Pavel Datsyuk saved a goal right there on the rebound, getting his stick in the lane. They had a wide open net and could not get the puck up thanks to Datsyuk's stick. It was Ruotsalainen.
Howard the save, and a ricochet off a body in front and just wide. Uses the net as a nice block there to lead the Red Wings out as Tatar brings it in. Nyquist going on the left wing. Back at the save. Sabres don't get it out. Shane with a shot at the goal post. Change direction on the way through.
But you do.
You do because everybody understands.
Shot by Franz and again. He must have had six shots high over top of the net tonight. As the Sabres, two of them are in. The shot, the save by Howard off Johan Larsson for that one. And then the Red Wings will close out in the afternoon in St. Louis. Cool. Rebound in front of the net. Held up there. Scores! It's 2-1. Helm, Glendening, and Miller. The Red Wings, their first lead of the game.
Face-offs. Boy, and they create the opportunity for the puck to end up in the back of the net. Darren Helm won the draw. Glendening goes to the front. He gets a piece of it, or he did, maybe not, and Helm just picked it out of the crowd and stutter stepped to the far side and dumped it in the open net. Wow. And they couldn't get back to cover him quickly. What a strange goal off a face-off win. A couple of bounces off skates, and the Red Wings are up 2-1.
And Miller in front was able to tie up Ristolainen enough, too. Chance for Delorier. He scored Friday night as well, his first NHL goal. Shane goes after it again and has it as the Red Wings are in the midst of a change. Backhanded through to Franzen. Good play, but it went off the stick of McBain to the corner. Weber trying to tie up Franzen, who brought it to the front of the goal.
Pretty good chance right there.
Sure was. Cater's chip in, hit McCabe, and then Quincy will fire it. Going down heavily was Foligno at center. He's still John at Quincy. Well, he didn't like that.
They
and two Red Wings go down. Yurko and Abdelkader collide as Ennis takes a shot. Howard made the save. Foligno's got it. McCabe played it ahead for Tyler Ennis. Look at that. Bouncing. It's like he's in the pregame skate. Then had his pocket picked by Alfredson. Daniel Alfredson back to the line. Stepping into one. Cronwall just wide. Helm with another shot. And bodies in front. I'm not sure if Hackett got a piece of that or not. Helm comes back to the line. There were defensemen flying everywhere. Helm goes back. Alfredson the shot.
Wow.
And that stopped it up into the netting and out of play. Whoa, that came up and got Kindle in the face. Right in front of the Red Wing bench. Pete Van Zandt right there. Ready to hop over the boards, but Kindle's right at the door and going to get off himself, I think, to the bench.
The linesman says, well, he's a hockey player. All right. He got popped in and he's spitting blood. The linesman standing there with his back to him.
Well, good thing he didn't lose the 10 teeth like Mitch Callahan did the other night with Grand Rapids.
I was thinking about that the other day. Why do we get so much of that? It's the speed of the game. It's just way too fast.
Whoa, that hit him in the head. Whoa, that stunned just what the Sabres need. Another goaltender injured, and they already have a concussion. Nathan Lewin in similar fashion against Philadelphia on Sunday. Rochester, look at this, right in the head. That's how Lewin got hurt and got concussed against the Flyers. Wow.
It's hard to believe they can't get out of the way. And you, geez, I tell you, I think this went off a defenseman's stick.
You never know. Better safe. Drew Miller, wide open. There's Helm up the middle. And checked at the last second on a good defensive play coming back.
Yes, indeed. 4:32 to go. And Pavel Datsyuk with a little bit of his mastery here. Cuts to the middle. He's juking and jiving and deacon. And at the end, he a little frustrated there. And here he tries to play keep away. Does a pretty good job of it.
Just under 18, around 17:45 in each of the first two games. So the most yet. Here's a turnover. Leg one. Scores! The Red Wings scored three for a seventh consecutive game, and they have a two-goal lead, 3-1.
Credit Drew Miller for keeping this puck alive and inside the zone. Watch the play right as they come to right there. Drew Miller collides with the Sabres, chips it back in. Even though Ligwan wants to pass this puck to Glenn Denning, he says, I can't. They leave me the lane. I got to shoot it. And there's the play by Miller right there. Nice job. He should get an assist on it. Two-goal lead, Detroit. Ligwan's 11th point.
And for Drew Miller, his 100th career point.
Way to go, Drew.
As he gets the assist on that one. So Drew Miller gets a milestone marker. They could knock two off that ledger. Brought back in by Gergensen. Oh. He's cutting to the goal, and he scores. Great move.
Well, I guess so.
That third goal looks big now, doesn't it?
Well, this is a great move. Boy, does he ever bring the puck to the forehand quickly. He got Cronwall stutter step just for a little bit and chucked it inside. So many players are trying this play in today's world. And Cronwall's just not necessarily standing up, but partly, and that gave him the room to go to the outside and bring it back to the middle and beat Jimmy Howard to the far side.
Brendan Smith, safe play, put it to the near corner, but Buffalo will grab it. D'Agostini tries to center, he couldn't. Gergensen's got knocked down. In front came loose side of the goal. Pavel Datsyuk in defensive posture made
nice
the play
job.
And a great play
That's a
by
great
Datsyuk.
Play by Datsyuk to stick with it. Second
Bronson
and third
across
effort.
Center to the empty net. That's knocked down though by Pesek. Pesek played it back. Erhoff just onside to Hodgson. Howard skipped it in back of the goal. He wants to hold it and he will. DeKeyser off an important faceoff, and it's tipped by Miller. Good job. It's back into the Buffalo zone. Erhoff to get it. 10 seconds left. Sabres can't get through. Datsyuk clears it down the ice. The backhander scores! Pavel Datsyuk with 5 seconds left. Seals this for Detroit to make it 4-2, the Red Wings' magic number to make the playoffs for a 23rd consecutive year is down to 1.
Well, if anybody can score from the other side of center ice with soft hands and a wonderful touch, you're looking at him right there. Number 13. Watch this puck take a couple of short hops. Look at this thing. It hits the back of the net about a foot and a half up, and only a guy like Datsyuk can make it happen like that. Look at that crazy hop right there.
So the Detroit Red Wings have now beaten Buffalo 8 straight, and really none bigger than this one. And for Mike Babcock, passes Jack Adams for the most wins in Detroit Red Wings history as head coach. So congrats to Mike, and congrats to the Red Wings, and a big win and a big game for Jimmy Howard, Mick, as Detroit now needs just one is the magic number to make the playoffs.
Well, coming in here, you expect to beat the Buffalo Sabres, but you never guarantee it, and this game didn't go down easy, just like the one Friday night with Buffalo scoring first and then getting a 5-on-3. That may have really gave the momentum to Detroit, but Howard not tested severely tonight, but good when he had to be, and the Red Wings find a way to scrap it out